The Pacific Ocean is 48% of the world's ocean. In this ocean area, the Western and Central Pacific is a key region for tuna. Over half of the global total tuna catch is taken in the Western and Central Pacific Ocean. Key tuna species in the region are skipjack, big eye, yellowfin, and albacore. In 2019, the total catch of these four key tuna species in the convention area of the Western and Central Pacific Fisheries Commission, the region's fisheries management organization, was a record high at just under 3 million metric tons. The WCPO is currently the only ocean region with all four key tuna species in a healthy state, being neither overfished nor experiencing overfishing. Over 55% of the key tuna catch comes from within the waters of the Pacific Island countries and territories, and many of these countries rely on the continued sustainability of the tuna stocks to obtain important national income and employment opportunities for their people. Also, some countries have a strong and increasing reliance on tuna as a source of protein. The percentage of purseiners flagged to Pacific Island states has increased steadily for 20 years and now represents almost 50% of purseiners licensed to fish in the WCPFC convention area. For decades, the Pacific community has provided tuna science expertise in the Pacific region by providing regional stock assessments, scientific analysis, and advice to support evidence-based fisheries management, monitoring tuna stock and ecosystem health in partnership with its members through the WCPFC region's tuna tagging program, vessel and observer log sheets, and tuna biological sampling programs. Member countries provide their fisheries data to SPC's data management team to underpin SPC's technical work and advice, building the capacity of its membership in all these areas. For over 40 years, the Foreign Fisheries Agency has been supporting its Pacific Island members to take collective and national action for the management of their offshore fisheries resources. FFA works to ensure its members can enjoy the greatest possible social and economic benefits from the sustainable use of offshore fisheries resources. This has been delivered by innovative fisheries management and legal advice to help countries secure the rights to the fishery resources and manage the tuna stocks within their 200-mile exclusive economic zones, combating illegal, unregulated, and unreported IUU fishing through cutting-edge technologies and regional surveillance operations, economic data and analysis to support countries to maximize economic returns and enhance social benefits, facilitating regional cooperation and solidarity to support Pacific Island countries to work together to protect and benefit from the sustainable use of their tuna resources. Through cooperation and solidarity, FFA member countries are working together to protect the region's tuna stocks and secure benefits for current and future generations. The WCPFC is the organization in charge of determination of the regional total allowable catches or total levels of fishing effort, adopting conservation and management measures, adopting standards for collection, verification, and timely exchange of data, compiling and disseminating accurate and complete statistical data. The members of the PNA control 50% of the global supply of skipjack tuna, the most commonly canned tuna. The focus of PNA efforts to sustainably manage tuna is the vessel day scheme. PNA members agree on a limited number of fishing days for the year, based on scientific advice about the status of the tuna stocks. Fishing days are then allocated by member country EEZ and sold to the highest bidder. In this way, Pacific Islanders reap economic benefits from their sustainable management of tuna. This high-quality science, advice, and support, and the member country's commitment, has resulted into effective evidence-based fisheries management decision-making. For the future, continued proactive management of the stock based on the best available scientific advice is needed to ensure the continued sustainability of the stocks and fisheries and the benefits derived from them.